oyster. It trickles upon its journey through a maze of metal-piped clockwork, digging a grave of wet puddles. You are unsheathed, fulgent in the harsh and heavy moonlight, mortal flesh feeble against the coarse eclipse. Its scalding meniscus swallows exhausted legs, sharply cut, jagged across your neck. You remember your childhood. You want to be a mermaid again, sinless. You remove your hair catcher and let it fall in tendrils of dense waves. You are tamed by the lullabies of distant traffic, nonchalantly allowing yourself to be consumed. It creeps into your ears until all you can hear is the resounding echo of futility. Atrium, ventricle, artery, lungs, repeats, and then it invades your airways, alveoli half flooded in achromatic despair. It attempts to muffle the sonorous ring of church bells. They augment, and soon they rip the auditory nerve, thunderous in their voyage across the amygdala. Your eyes flare open. Freshly woken from a carnivorous nightmare, daffodil candlelight infuses the retina. It stops clinging to you, cascading like a waterfall emerging from seaweed depths. Screams of merciless beasts resuscitate the silence, and it drowns, gushing upon its descent through the black hole at the bottom of the bathtub.